All right, Shalom, all praise to y'all, Bashem al Shai, double honors to my apostles and elders, great millstone, and peace and blessings to you brothers out there doing the work in truth and sincerity, in season and out of season, preaching his truth. All right, so brother Knock, I'm going to go do a quick lesson. All right, quick lesson, all right, because got scoffers and scorners, you know, got scoffers and scorners coming against brothers, you know, coming against brothers' pages, you know, they'll watch the videos and call you a fool, you know, say that, This truth is not real. All right, those are just demons. All right, because we have a sure foundation. All right, through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Al Shai, that the words in these scriptures, all right, are true. And we know because what the spirit that dwells inside us, is linked up. All right, and it's one in one accord with the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Al Shai. All right. And what these people don't understand is that the Lord, he actually gave us the spirit to understand and believe this truth, all right? At the same time, you do got demons. You got demons, spirits that hop on people to come against you, all right? And not all men have faith and not all men believe this truth, all right? Now, should that make the scriptures not true? No, of course not. We actually see the prophecies coming to pass, all right? Now you got scoffing scorners saying that the Most High is not real. All right, and man, that's just crazy, you know. Which the majority are Edomites, all right. Which the majority are Edomites, which proves that the scriptures are true, because we know Esau, he's a carnal man, all right, and he's all about carnality, all right. He's all about the flesh, you know, and he's not spiritual, man. He's not spiritual, so he can't get this. That's why he relies on his science. He relies on his science, and his science really is just what the Most High gave him, the little knowledge that the Most High gave him, all right, and he doesn't know anything, all right. And if you believe that there is no power, all right, that the universe just appeared or out of nowhere, I mean, man, you're out of your damn mind, literally, you know, like literally, you're out of your damn mind. You're basically saying that anything can happen, all right, you know, that just anything can just pop out, anything can just magically appear. Okay, let me go right into the script. This is Psalms 14:1. It's a Psalm of David. It says, "The fool hath said in his heart, there is no power." All right, there is no God. Okay, they are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There's none that doeth good. There's none that doeth good, man. These people who say that that there is no power, man. There is no power that created them. All right, that the universe. And they adhere to Esau's evolutionary theory, which is a theory, which Esau tells you in a roundabout way. But you people are so stupid and you don't look into words, okay? And you don't really see behind the hypocrisies. You don't really see behind a lie that the so-called white man is giving you. All right, he's telling you that this is a theory, okay? The evolutionary theory, that the Big Bang theory, all right? Darwinism. Just another form of what? White supremacy, because what? All the other nations prior to Esau taking them down had their gods, man. Esau even had his own god. All right, but now Esau's god, Esau has many gods, okay? And one of those gods is atheism. That's the god too, man, because you have to believe in that, man. You have to actually believe that there is no power, which that is a belief, okay? You have faith in that, okay? So they're that's why the scriptures say that they're corrupt. And done abominable works, man. These people are—they're just crooked because they have what? There's no checks and balances, all right. So they're totally on the left-hand side. It's totally wicked. Just totally wicked, man. They done they're into all type of abominable sins, all right. There's none that do of good, man. So you got a guy that's saying that there is no power, man. There is no God, all right. He's somebody that should just get put to death immediately, and it's gonna happen, man. It's going to happen. So when all the hell breaks loose, I want you to call on the universe, man. I want you to call on Darwin and see if his ass going to help you. All right? No, nobody's going to help you, all right? Them angels going to be slaying you, all right? The last scripture, cuz I'm just going to wrap it up, all right? This is Romans 3:3. For what if some did not believe? Shall their unbelief make the faith of the Most High without effect? Most High forget. Yea, let the Most High be true, but every man a liar, as it is written, that thou mightest be justified in thy sayings and mightest overcome what thou art judged. All right. Now, should just because you have an unbeliever, just because you have an unbeliever, does that mean that the scriptures are broken? That means we should just drop everything. Okay, I'm going to just close the scriptures. All right, I should just close the scriptures, cut it up, burn it, and just go into the world and just be a bug out? Is that what you guys are trying to say? All right? To all the non-believers, Israelites, especially to you Israelites, all right? All right? But, you got Edomites come on my page and other brothers' page, say that God is not real, the truth is not real. All right, well, at the end of the day, we're going to see who God is real, man. And you know what? I have 100% confidence that Yahweh Shemal Shai is real. You guys don't. That's why you guys are totally out of your mind. You don't know what's going on. The Most High, he actually gave us a spirit to know what's going on. And you guys are totally, and we're telling you, and it's going in one ear and out the other, man. That's a spirit, though. You know, that's a spirit. You guys got the spirit of reprobates on you. Okay? So with that, man, hey, you non-believers, man, you're just going to be destroyed, all right? You're going to be destroyed, and Yahweh Shemal Shai's men are gonna rule in righteousness, okay? And at the end of the day, you're gonna see that Yahweh Shemal Shai is real, man. He's gonna really make his name present, all right? And he's gonna send his son out here, all right? He's gonna send his son, and I want you to tell his son to his face that the Most High is not real. And with that, I want to say Shalom.